Yellow, how's it going everyone? Lord360 here, and today, in part 2 of part 3 of the Halloween special, Lord360 finds a dead body. Let's try that again, alright? Yellow, how's it going everyone? Lord360 here, back with another episode. And this is part 2 of 3 of the Halloween series for the Pokémon Go event. And in this video today, I go hunting for some new stops and the costume Pokémon. So we're going to try and see if we can find one of each of them, because there are a lot of them out there, the Pikachus at least, but the raids themselves haven't been spawning as much as like the Mischievous and the Drifloons, at least for level 1 raids around me. I've been seeing more of those. I don't know about you guys, let me know in the comment section what you guys have been finding, but I've been finding that. And I also apologize about the lack of upload last week. I know I missed a week, but I've been pretty busy with school and everything, so hopefully you guys can understand. But we're back at it, alright? This week's gonna be 2 uploads, so A, awesome. And the next week's gonna be the Colossal event, which is going to be the paid event. I'll be putting that up. And then hopefully I can get part 3 out to you before then. But I'll try my best. I don't know if I'll definitely get it out 100% for the Halloween part 3 next week, but I'll definitely try my best. So without further ado, let's go to the first raid, which is a Bulbasaur.
We're here at our first raid for the costume Pokemon. We're here for the Bulbasaur. And we're going in with the fam. We're going in with my sister and my mom. So hopefully, we'll be able to get this down in no time, and I'll bring you guys back once we take it down. Well, that didn't take long. There we go. We took him down. Also get those revives. Don't need them anymore, but we'll take them. And there's our cute little Bulbasaur. Put our golden rods on it so I don't have to worry about trying to do a perfect throw on it. There we go. Let's see. One. Oh, he's gonna jump out. That's no fun. Let's try this again. My throws are bad, but that's because I only have the one finger going. Oh boy. Throwing with the thumb is not the easiest. I'm gonna try curving it. And he attacked on it. Okay. Woo! There we go. Alright, we got a good hit on it. Let's see. One. Two. There we go. We caught it. Sweet. And what are the IVs gonna look like? Let's have a look. Oh, not bad. 14 attack. There you go. And you cannot evolve these guys. So if you wanted to make it into an Ivysaur, you unfortunately can't. So once you have it like that, it stays like that for the rest of its lifetime in your box. All right. Now we're gonna head on to the next raid.
Good morning, everyone. We have found raid number 2 for the costume Pokemon. This one is indeed for the Squirtle with the Yamask top hat. Oh, I love this guy. Let's take him down. He's not gonna take us too long, honestly. And on my way here, I also did find a shiny Mischievous. That was pretty cool. And there we go. That was pretty fast. We already took the Squirtle down. Also had someone helping us, so you know, that helps a lot. Alright, so we're looking at 526, I thought I saw. Let's have a look. And there it is. 525, okay, so I was off by 1 CP. Alright, let's catch this guy. This is gonna be a lot easier than the Bulbasaur, I hope. Because Bulbasaur was a pain in the butt. Okay, 1, 2. Okay, no, they made these costume Pokemon hard to catch, even for being a 1 star. Woo! Or I'm just really bad at throwing lately. There we go. Alright, so we hit it that time. Let's see. One. Two. Come on. There we go. Alright, sweet. We got the Squirtle. Oh, man. Let's see the IVs on it, because if it's really good, you know, I'm going to want to keep at least one of each of these if I do more of them. Perfect attack! Sweet. Alright, let's try and find the Charmander, and I'll bring it back when I find it.
I'm not a Charmander raid, am I? No, I'm not. Because I didn't get a chance to bring the camera while I found my first one. I will put the screen recording on the screen right now. But the Charmander raids haven't been spawning that much. Like, as of right now, I only have like 2 or 3 of them at most. And They're just not spawning. But here you go. I thought I'd at least show you that I actually did one, and I caught it. And now we're going to head off towards the new stops portion. This was for the quest line for the special research for Spirit Tomb. So let's get going. Alright, so now we're on a little segment I like to call Find That New Stop. So what we're gonna do is we're working on the spin 8 stops you haven't visited before. So we've got two right here at the Jack Wiggins Park. So let's get this one spun right here. Perfect. And then let's get the other one spun. Beautiful. What I'm also gonna do is I'm gonna do a little scenery view of each park, and then from there, we're gonna just try and see if we can get some new stops. We're gonna go to each one, and then we're gonna do a little scene of each one. So you guys are ready? Let's go on an adventure. Okay, we're at our third destination, and we're at the Massey Park Playground. That is the stop that I've never spun before either, and to be honest, I had no reason to really come here. It's kind of secluded away from where I actually play, which is the gym, which actually used to be a stop as well, so that is pretty cool. And nothing really here except for that quest, so on to number 4. Harry A. Shields Parkette, which is another stop that I could have just gotten, but I didn't. And it was mainly because I felt like something's gonna happen with these stops again. But hey, you know what? It worked out in the end. I got another stop. It's right by my house too. You can see it right in the distance there. There it is, all the way at the end, across the lake, which is a nice lake. Oh boy. Man, I'm just getting so tired because it's so windy out, so I'm losing my breath just biking around. Also, on top of the bike, it's the last time I'll be biking around for a while. Winter's coming around, so gotta pack them up for the season. But it'll definitely come back again next year for sure. Probably do some bike raid hours as well, just for the fun of it. But we're gonna head to the next stop, all right? Fall is truly a time for some wonderful colors, and unfortunately I have nothing really to say about this one. It's just a new stop that was added maybe a day or two ago, and that gym over there is used to be a gym. It used to be a stop, what am I saying? Yeah, get going to the next one, which in my opinion, this is gonna be my favorite place to visit because I've only come here maybe once or twice, and it is just a beautiful place. All right, I'll take you guys there now. All right, I lied on my last statement. I said it was a really beautiful place. I forgot on the way that we had Naismith Park have a new stop behind the actual sign. So there you go, another new stop. And I'm also gonna spin that one because, what's the quest? Evolve Pokemon, that's a good one. It's for a Cubone, so it might be shiny. And now I will take you to that nice beautiful spot that I was talking about.
I've only visited once, but I came here before the stop actually was introduced, and that is the Colored Bridge Overpass, also known as the Birch Pedestrian Mural. Yes, there we go, we're at 7 of 8. So, I'm gonna reach our last spot. It's a bit noisy here, I don't wanna keep you too long, alright? Alright, I can say with great pleasure that La France Park Playground is our 8th and final new stop spun in Brampton. Man, there are still so many stops that I haven't spun in Brampton, but hey, that's at least some of them. So now that we've completed all that, we can finally claim our rewards. So, first one's gonna be our Spirit Tomb. I don't actually know the 100% IVs on it, so I'm gonna just shoot in faith and hope that this is going to be our 100% Spirit Tomb. Come on. No, okay. Oh, that is cool. Just the tombstone part of it comes out of the actual shell. Oh, that's so cool. My bad. I mean, okay. Look at that. Boom. There we go. We got him. Now we're gonna see. Was the IVs better than my last year's one? Not bad. Not bad at all. Definitely 100% though. And we can also claim this one. What is it gonna be? Yeah, mask. Okay. So they give you a free yeah mask and a free Litwick if you complete the quest. That's a good reward. There we go. Alright. There we go. Come on. And a 1, 2. There we go. Got him. Perfect. Are the IVs gonna be good? Because I don't know the IV checks on the quest either. It's gonna be, wow, a 96. That's actually pretty good. All right, and Merco check? No. All right, I will catch you guys back home and we'll do the rest of our little house cleaning stuff.
All right, we finally made it back to the house. I hope you guys really enjoyed that, going touring around Brampton a little bit. I haven't really cleaned up Brampton in a while for new stops, and there could be more added now since Canadians have the nominations, which I will make a video eventually on how to nominate stops. But for now, it just turned to be raining, and we're gonna start screen recording now, because that would be useful. Let's check a Ghastly. No, not shiny, but we did find one of those in the first video, so that was pretty good. Looking at the recent shinies we have though, there's a lot of them, because I haven't really updated you guys in the last while. Got my first Houndour, so good. Oh, I'm so happy with him. He's been so elusive forever, but I finally managed to get my own. Another Poochyena, Sableye, which actually I haven't found one since its first initial release. So that's 2 years worth of not finding shiny Sableye since it came out. Crazy, but I finally found it. Mischievous, Makuhita, this was the huge one. I finally got my shiny Patrat. So what I'm going to do for you guys right now as well is I'm going to evolve it. Doesn't really make much sense with the event right now, but I love the way it looks. So here you go, you get my live reaction of it. And I think it turns green in the body when it lights up. So that was the main reason why I really wanted to do this one. Look at that! Ooh, that's so good. Look at that. That is cool. And the IVs on it were actually pretty decent. Not great attack, but you can't really complain about that. And then the Ghastly and the Murkrow. And then community, obviously. And I also want to show you in terms of the costume Pokemon. For the Squirtles, we're up to 6 of them. For the Bulbasaur, we're up to 6 of them. And for the Charmanders, we're up to 4 of them. Plus a Shadow one, which I don't know why I have in there, but I guess I'll clean it up later. And that's gonna be really it for part 2. And the thing else really to show you that I really need to show you at the moment. And that's actually been going pretty good. I haven't been able to find any of the costume shiny Pokemon, but that's perfectly fine if I'm finding other cool shiny Pokemon. I can eventually get those through trade for the costume ones, but at least have one of every single costume Pokemon. So part 3, I said at the beginning, will be delayed just a little bit because of the Colossal research event for the Regigigas, but I'll get it out to you guys eventually, all right? Don't even worry about it. So, and I have a very special surprise for part 3 that nobody's gonna expect. Alright? So, as always, thank you so much for watching. Make sure to boom, hit the like button, Click through the button down below to subscribe to the channel and hit bubble beside it so you know if I want to put a new video. I've been LordDrew360, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Take care, everybody.